Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk to you about how to plan for your best year ever. On this channel, we'll discuss topics such as personal finance, minimalism, and self-improvement. So if you are new, make sure that you subscribe. Okay, I'm going to hop into the video, but before I do, don't forget to hit the like button. So step one is to reflect. So before you start planning for the new year, it's very important that you reflect on the past year and really see what went well and what didn't and why that is, because that's going to give you a lot of insight on what worked and what didn't and why, and that's going to be really helpful for you when you go to plan for the new year. So for example, if you completely forgot about your goals because you didn't write them down, then maybe this year something that you can add to your plan is to write down your goals and to check in every month to make sure that you're kind of following up on your goals. Step two is to envision the life that you want and the reality that you really want to create, and then you want to ask yourself what you see. It's important to be really clear and specific about the big picture because it's going to give you a guideline for exactly where you need to go. Because sometimes we set all of these goals, but at the end of the day, the goals that we set, they're not necessarily leading us towards like the dream life that we want. So it's important to kind of envision what you really want first before you actually break it down into smaller steps. Step three is to know your why. Why do you want these things, and why do you want to create this life? Are you looking for external validation? Is it because of societal pressure? Is it because this is what you're supposed to be doing? Your most important motivator is going to be your why. And if it's something that's external, it's not going to be as effective on days where you're just not in the mood. You need to do it for yourself rather than for others. For example, if you're trying to lose weight and you're planning to exercise every single day, but you're doing it because you want to look good for other people and you want to impress other people, then on a day where you're just not in the mood, that why isn't going to be strong enough impressing other people. You're not going to necessarily care. It has to be for you. And on the other hand, if you're doing it because you want to be healthy and you want to be strong and you want to boost your confidence, then even if you're tired, that's going to be a lot more motivating to you than just doing it for other people. Number four is to prioritize. You always want to prioritize the most important things in your life. I would honestly not set more than 5 goals at a time because I think it's a lot easier and more attainable to only focus on 5 things at a time, because you can always set more goals once you've reached some of the ones that you've already set, or once you feel like you're in a really comfortable place and you're making great strides towards those 5 goals. And I think it's important to just set 1 goal for each area of your life. So maybe 1 goal for work, 1 goal for your financial life, and 1 goal for your personal life. You don't want to overwhelm yourself by setting too many goals, because then there's just too much going on and you're kind of trying to change everything at once, and that is a very difficult thing to do. I think it's always easier to start small and change one area of your life, or take one small step and wait until that becomes a part of your routine before you add on more. The last thing you want to do is take on too much and then just completely give up because you feel overwhelmed. Number five is to set reach goals. So set goals that are a little bit higher than what you think you can achieve. Don't be super unrealistic with it. But for example, if you think that realistically you can run maybe like an 8-minute mile, then what you want to do is set a reach goal. So maybe you would say that your goal is to run a 7.5-minute mile. And the reason you want to set reach goals is because it's going to motivate you and push you sort of past your limit. And it's the idea of setting yourself up for success by expecting more from yourself. And if you've ever played like a sport where you had to play a team that was a lot better, and all of a sudden you and your whole team is playing much better than you guys ever have, it's kind of like that. It's about setting yourself up for success by expecting more and kind of pushing yourself harder. Because when you push your limits and your boundaries, sometimes you end up surprising yourself by how much you will actually accomplish. Number six is to create a realistic timeline. I think as humans, we have a way of procrastinating and kind of using up all of the time that we have. So if you've ever had like a project that was due in 2 weeks, but for the first 2 weeks, you had no idea how to do the project, and then 2 hours before the project's due, all of these ideas come flooding into, and you're just like typing furiously. It's the stress of the deadline. It really pushes you to, I guess, perform better than you normally would. And I think it's important to create like that sense of urgency for yourself by setting a timeline for your goals, because a goal without a timeline is really just a dream. you're not necessarily going to feel the pressure of the deadline, and it's not necessarily going to motivate you to work towards that goal. When you have a deadline, it just makes it a lot more real, and it makes you feel like you need to really be working on this. And this is also going to make your goals a lot more measurable if you set a timeline. So for example, go back to the mile timeline. So if you say, I want to run a 7.5 minute mile, but you don't say like by when, then it's kind of random, and it feels like you can just do it whenever. But if you say, I want to run a 7.5 minute mile in 3 months, then that realistically sets you up, and you kind of have to break that down. Like, okay, if I have 3 months, then, you know, each month I have to be this much closer to my goal, otherwise I'm not actually going to get there. So it just makes it a lot easier for you to actually achieve your goal, because it breaks everything down and it gives you like a direct guideline for how to get to your goals. Number 7 is to create habits and systems that will set you up for success. So if your goal is to wake up early every day and go for a run, then lay out all of your workout clothes the night before and make sure that you go to bed at like a proper time so that you can actually get up early and go for a run. The easier you make it for yourself, the more likely you are to be successful in accomplishing your goals. Number 8 is to get a partner or find a support group. It's always going to be easier to do something if you have a group of like-minded people who are striving for the same things. Not only can they provide you with the support that you need, but they might also have really great tips to help you kind of get to where you want to be faster. Number 9 is to work on your self-image. Sometimes when we fail at things, it's because we never believed that we could have achieved it in the first place. So it's important to really reevaluate your self-image and what you think is possible for yourself. Sometimes it's not even really a conscious thought, but it can be really detrimental nonetheless. One thing I find to be really helpful with this is to start with small goals. When you accomplish something, even if it's a really small goal, it kind of gives you a boost of confidence, and it makes you feel like, oh, I accomplished this goal, so I can accomplish even more goals. And every time you accomplish a small goal, that feeling just kind of compounds until you have so much confidence and you feel like you can really accomplish anything that you want and you can really conquer the world. And I know it sounds a little bit silly, but I promise it really works. So just start small if you're kind of not sure what to do. Number 10 is to stay positive. I've said it before and I'm going to say it again. Whenever you go into something, if you go into it with a positive attitude, it's always going to help you. So just be grateful for the things that you do have. Be positive about what you can accomplish, and don't let negativity and self-doubt kind of prevent you from the life that you want. If you truly believe that you can, then you're going to get so much further than you ever expected to. Alright guys, that was it for today's little video. I hope you liked it. If you did, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye!